Rekatataya si anderia, randebro wasu ande, makabataya su ande, makabro wasu anderia. Father, we bless your holy name, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we say, worthy are you, Lord, worthy are you, Lord. Worthy are you, Lord, worthy are you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we bless your holy name, Lord. We magnify you, Lord. We exalt your holy name, Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekatataya su anderia, rantable de ramasia. Rekatataya su ande rantable de ramasi katataya rendeble de. Father, we bless your holy name, Lord. We magnify you in the name of Jesus. We come before you, O commander of the angels army. We come before you, Lord. We magnify your holy name, Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We say thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for preserving our life, O Lord. Thank you for how far you have brought us, O Lord, your goodness. In the name of Jesus, we say we appreciate you, Lord. We hold you in high esteem, Lord. We magnify your magnificent name, Lord. We thank you for your protection, O Lord. We thank you for your provision that you have provided for us, O Lord. We thank you for your visitation coming into our crisis, O Lord, and visiting us, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, we say we are grateful. We are grateful unto you, King of Kings. We are grateful, O Lord, unto you for your traveling mercy. In the name of Jesus, for all your provisions upon our lives. We thank you for the daily bread that you give unto us each and every day. We thank you, Lord. We bless your holy name for your fruitfulness. We bless you, Lord, for your productivity, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Retebro asu ande, reka ba 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 ya si anderia, rantable de, reka ba 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 ya si anderia, rantable de, reka ta 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 ya su anderia, randebro asu kaba ta ya su ande, rende de. Father, we bless your holy name, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We enter your gate this evening, O Lord, with your thanksgiving, with your password, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We say we thank you, O Lord, for granting us the permission to come before you, to come and service our altars, in the name of Jesus, to come and fulfill our covenantal duties, O Lord, with you this evening, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekabatataya su anderia, rantable de ramakanduria si anderia zikutu kabataya, rintable de ramasi ande, rekatatataya su kabababababaya, rantable de ramasi anderia makanduria su kataya, rintable de ramasi anderia. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for KHM and her branches, O Lord. We thank you for the pastorate. We thank you for the membership, O Lord. We are grateful for preserving our life. We are grateful for your goodness. We are grateful for your mercies. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for activating our angels, O Lord. We thank you for your direction, O Lord. We thank you for your infilling of the Holy Spirit, for pouring yourself unto us and leading us, O Lord. We thank you for causing your will to be done in our lives, O Lord. We thank you for causing us to live in you, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, O Lord, for causing us to live with you, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for helping us, O Lord, to live for you, in the name of Jesus, for our protection, our productivity, and our purpose to be fulfilled. We say we are grateful. We thank you for making us make strides. We thank you, O Lord, for your increase. increase. We thank you, Lord, for causing us to grow, for causing us to do well in the name of Jesus. We thank you for causing us to recognize our unique selling propositions in the name of Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. Father, thank you, Lord, we bless your holy name, Lord, we honor you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we say thank you, King of Kings, thank you, Lord of Lords, in the name of Jesus, Father, we bless you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Rande Brosu Andiria. We magnify your holy name, Lord. We exalt you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you, we honor you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekatataya su andi. Rantable masi andiria. Rentebru wasu kaba ba 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 ya si andiria. Rantable masi andiria ziku tu kabru wasi andi. Rantable masi andiria. Rekatatata ya su andi. Rantable masu andiria. Rekataya su andi. Father, we bless you, we bless you, we bless you, Lord. We honor your holy name, Lord. We exalt you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Kataya su andiria, rantable masi katataya su andi, randebro wasi andiria zikabataya, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, rekataya su andiria makabataya, rentebre masi andiria, randebro wasu andi, rekababababababababaya si andiria, rantabro wasu andiria zikataya, rentebre. In the name of Jesus, we bless your holy name, Lord. We honor you, King of Kings. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rakatataya suandi. Erintebre masi katatataya siandiria. Rantabro asu andiria zekataya. Rantable masi andiria zeku tu kabru asi andiria. Erintebre masi andi makataya. Rantable masu andiria zekataya siandi. Rantable masi andi. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekatata yasi andiria. Rantabre masukata yasi andiria. Zekutu kabru wasi andiria. Rantatata yasu andi. Rentebre masi andiria. Rantabru wasu kabababababababa yasi andiria. Rantabre masi andi. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your holy name, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rande bro wasu kata yasi andi. Erete bre de 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 rama kata ta yasu andiria. Ranta bre de 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 rama si andiria. Zika ba 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 ya. Re kata ta ta yasi andiria. Ranta bro wasu kaba ta yasi andi. Father, we magnify your holy name, Lord. We exalt you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We appreciate you tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekata yasu andiria. Rantabre de 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 ramasi andiria. Zika ba 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 ya. Rekata ta 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 ya. Randebro wasu andiria. Zika andiria su andi. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we honor your holy name, Lord. We bless your holy name, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rante bruwasi andiria. Reka tatata yasu andiria. Reka ba 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 yasi andiria. Rande bruwasu ka ba 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 yasi andiria. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Reka tayasu andiria. Ranta bruwasi andiria. Rente bre masi katatata ya. Rande bruwasu andiria. Zeka ba tayasu andi. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying. We are asking for mercy. We are saying that, Lord, as we come before you tonight, any sin that we might have committed, we are asking that, Father, you cleanse us and repair us. We confess that, Father, you forgive us. In the name of Jesus, somebody, let's ask for mercy, that the Lord will purge us tonight as we come before him. In the name of Jesus, ask for mercy. He said that as we come before him and we confess, he is just, he is faithful to forgive us. Ask for mercy. Ask God to forgive you of any sin of omission, any sin of commission, knowingly or unknowingly. Ask God to forgive you any besetting sin that prevents us from giving us, giving him our all. Ask for mercy in the name of Jesus. Father, as we come before you, we pray that you will have mercy on us. We pray that you will forgive us. We pray that you will consecrate us. You will wash us in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, let your mercies locate us tonight as we come before you in the name of Jesus. Forgive us of any sin that we might have committed, knowingly or unknowingly. We say, Lord, forgive us in the name of Jesus. We say, Lord, purge us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Consecrate us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Wash us and purify us as we come, in the name of Jesus. We pray, my Lord, my God, we avail ourselves unto you, O Lord, that you will forgive us of any sin, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Any utterances that we might have made, O Lord, that does not glorify you, we ask for mercy. Any thought that has come in there that does not bring glory unto you, we ask for mercy. Anything we might have looked, O Lord, that does not bring good, that does not glorify your name, we ask for mercy in the name of Jesus. Any gesture, any attitude, any behavior, any mannerism, we ask that, Father, you forgive us, O Lord, and grant us the grace that will help us live a righteous life, the grace that will help us so that sin will not have dominion over us. In the name of Jesus, may we do away with any besetting sins that we cannot do away with. We ask for the grace to be able to dissociate ourselves from those sins. In the name of Jesus, grant us the grace to live a holy life, a righteous life, a life that is acceptable unto you. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Father, wash us, O Lord, purify us, O Lord, consecrate us, O Lord. Lord. May the enemy not have any legal ground against us because of our sin, because of our utterances, because of our behavior, our attitude. So we ask for your mercy. Lord, forgive us as church. Forgive us if we've done anything that does not glorify you. Forgive us of anything that you wanted us to do that we did not do according to your will and your dictate. We come that you will forgive us. We come that you will purge us. We come that you will consecrate us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying again. We are saying that, Lord, we have come again seeking your face tonight. Pour yourself unto us. Let your Holy Spirit overshadow us. Let your Holy Spirit sit on us in the name of Jesus. We need the power from on high in the name of Jesus. The other day, the Bible said that when Jesus surrendered his will unto the Lord strengthened him. We are saying that, Lord, pour your spirit unto us and strengthen us in the name of Jesus for your assignment. In the name of Jesus, somebody, let's pray. That the Holy Spirit will fill us tonight. That the Holy Spirit will visit us tonight. In the name of Jesus. As we surrender our will unto him, he will fill us and give us the strength. Give us the enablement. Give us that strength that we need to go through. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Ask for him to ask for his inpouring. May he pour himself unto us. As we come before him empty, we are saying that, Lord, fill us, O Lord. Lord, for your assignment, fail us for us to be able to make strides. Fail us, oh Lord, that Father will be able to make that good decision that will cause us to be productive. Fail us, oh Lord, that we will make proper decision that will help us to dissociate away from any friend, enemies. In the name of Jesus, we need your infilling that will detect our steps. We want to walk in your steps. We want to step in your steps. We want to step in the spaces that you have provided for us to make strife in the name of Jesus. So we ask that, Father, pour yourself unto us, Lord. We need your Holy Spirit to overshadow us. We need that tangible manifestation of your presence. We want your presence to lead us in 2023 and beyond. So we come before you tonight emptying ourselves, that you will fill us in the name of Jesus, that you will strengthen us in the name of Jesus, that you will energize us, O Lord, for your mandate in the name of Jesus. We want to do it, oh Lord, but Father, we cannot do it on our own. So we ask for your strength. We ask for your empowering, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Pour your spirit unto us, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We need that grace, oh Lord, that Father will be able to be strengthened. We need your strength in time like this, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. In this time of counterfeits and clones, we need that strength that will help us stand on our feet, that zeal that will help us go ahead, that will help us, oh Lord, to move with the word. As we are being soaked with the word day and night, we pray for your strength to move with it in the name of Jesus. May no counterfeit, may no clone take us from your presence. We need that strength that will take us there in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, rin tebro wasu anderia, reka ba 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 ya si anderia, rin tebre de 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 masi kandoria si anderia, ran tabre de 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 masi ande. Amen. We are praying this prayer that, Lord, help me, that as I seek your face in this fast, may the power of the Holy Spirit come upon me so that I can also evangelize. I can win soul. The Bible said that those that win soul, they are wise. Said that the Bible said that when Peter and when they prayed and the Holy Spirit came upon them, they received the power from on high. And they went, the Bible said that they went to Samaria, Judea, and other places to proclaim the word. We are saying that as we are being fed with the word here, we are saying that, Lord, grant unto us that grace, that zeal that will help me to also speak your word to another, evangelize, win soul in the name of Jesus. We need that grace. Amen. Because of the season we find ourselves, the counterfeits and the clones that have that, like the mixed multitude, they have mixed up with that. So even if you have the good intent to even share the word with somebody because of what is happening, they also think you are also like them. But we are saying that, Lord, we need that grace that whatsoever they think, may we be able to tell them, preach the word to them. May we be able to draw them unto you in the name of Jesus. This time we need the grace to do it. And we are praying that, Lord, grant us the grace so that we'll be able to win more souls. The Bible said that he will draw men to himself. He will draw men to himself, but he will use us to draw those men. We are saying that, Lord, use me to win soul unto yourself in the name of Jesus. Somebody, let's pray that the Lord will use us to win soul for himself as we pray, as we receive from the pulpit. There are a lot of messages that we have been receiving. Father, may we also be able to share it unto our friends in the name of Jesus. We need the grace that will help us preach the word. We need the grace that will help us win the soul in the name of Jesus. Father, help us. On our own, we may feel shy. On our own, we may feel some way not to even do it because of the happenings. But we pray for that grace that will help us to be able to approach those people in the name of Jesus. Father, grant us the discernment spirit that will help us win those ones that, Father, you want them to come on board in the name of Jesus. We want to populate heaven and we want to depopulate hell. So we pray, my Lord, my God, that Father, you will help us to win soul. You said those that win souls unto you, they are wise. So as we seek your face in this prayer and fast, as you pour yourself unto us, we ask for that grace that will help us go out, oh Lord, to also proclaim, to also evangelize, to also win souls unto you in the name of Jesus. May you use us as channel to draw men unto yourself in the name of Jesus. We ask for this grace, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Where we fall short in this wise, in this direction, we pray that, Father, strengthen us in this sense, in this direction, that we may also be able to draw men unto you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, strengthen us, O Lord, that, Father, we will win souls unto you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, help us, Holy Spirit. We need that grace, O Lord, that will help us proclaim thy word as we receive from your pulpit here. Father, may we also go all out with it, O Lord, and broadcast it, proclaim it in the name of Jesus. As we receive your good tidings here, may we also go and deliver it, O Lord, unto the people that we have destined to receive your word in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, may I be a soul winner in the name of Jesus. May I be a soul winner in the name of Jesus, that I will win more souls in the name of Jesus unto your kingdom. Help us, O Lord, to do it as you want us to do it, not as we want to do, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, help us, O Lord, to win more souls, O Lord, unto you, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, rande brewasuka baba baba yasi andiria rantabre de 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 masi. In the name of Jesus, amen. We are praying this prayer. I want us to pray for Kingdom Harvesters Ministry. We are praying for all our branches. Amen. That the Lord would visit us as we all go through this fast. The Lord will visit us. The Lord will touch us. The Lord will cause his face to shine upon us. He said that his beaming face will shine upon us. His sunrise face will shine upon us with the glory that comes with his face. We are saying that, Lord, touch your church. He said that you will build your church and the gates of hell will not prevail. We are saying that, Lord, cause us to thrive. Amen. Cause us to increase. Cause us to do well. Cause us to do as you want us to do in the name of Jesus. And all those that mixed multitude that are in there preventing us from thriving, we are taking them, eliminating them, dissociating ourselves from it. In the name of Jesus, we are praying for Shama. We are praying for Accra. We are praying for Kumasi. We are praying for all those places that we have branches there. In the name of Jesus, somebody, let's pray for Kingdom Harvesters nationwide, worldwide, globally. In the name of Jesus, that there will be the visitation of the Lord, that as we seek his face in this fast, he will touch us and he will manifest himself unto us. He will cause us to do well. He will fulfill his destiny. He will fulfill us. He will cause us to do well. He will cause us to increase in number. He will cause us to flourish. He will cause us to make strides. He will cause us to do as he wants us to do, in the name of Jesus, that the Lord will touch his church, that the gate of hell will not prevail, in the name of Jesus. We pray, my Lord, my God, our Father, touch our branches, O Lord. May we be the hallmark of miracles, in the name of Jesus. May we be the solution center, in the name of Jesus. We pray, my Lord, my God, that you will touch each and everybody who is connected to this altar, in the name of Jesus. May their heart desires be fulfilled. Anything they have brought before you, we pray, my Lord, my God, that as we fast, you say, how can this be unless by prayer and fasting? We are saying that those live streamers, we pray, wherever they are, in the name of Jesus, Father, may you touch them, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Our Telegram channel people, Lord, touch them. Our YouTube people, touch them. Our Facebook people, touch them. Our Mizzle people, Father, touch them, in the name of Jesus. Anyone that tuned in, O Lord, to feed from this pulpit, we pray, my Lord, my God, that, Father, you will bless us, O Lord. You will bless them. You will increase them. You will cause us to make strides, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that your goodness will manifest in our lives, in the name of name of Jesus. Re kata tata ya si andiria rande masu kata tata ya. We pray, my Lord, my God, that Father, you will answer us by fire, in the name of Jesus. That Father, may you answer us by fire. We pray, though, Lord, that you answer us by fire. May the angels that are assigned to Kingdom Harvesters Ministry, we pray that, Father, may they be activated. You are the commander of the angels armies. Father, we pray that may you command the angels that are connected or that are destined for Kingdom Harvesters Ministry. Father, may you discharge them tonight into our favor, that they will war for us, they will fight for us, in the name of Jesus, that each and every member, anyone connected, will be blessed in the name of Jesus. That as we seek your face in this fast, O Lord, may our prayers get unto you, O Lord. Lord, may it not be blocked by any demon, any prince of Persia, in the name of Jesus. May your angels deploy, O Lord, that any prayer that is being blocked, may the angels pave the way. May the airspace open unto us. May your heavens open unto us, O Lord, for us to receive our blessing, in the name of Jesus, that there will be more testimonies, in the name of Jesus, that there will be more testimonies. We will do this fast and come and testify and come and give you the glory and come and give you all the honor, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray that you touch our church, O Lord. Touch our church, O Lord. Touch our church, O Lord. KHM will do well. KHM will thrive. KHM will make strides, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And your increase will be our portion. Amen. We can't pray for KHM without praying for the vision bearer. We are praying for Daddy. From since when? He has been standing, preaching, ministry, anointing. Which one? Ninina. Amen. We are saying that, Lord, strengthen him. Let your gracious son, the many-sided grace, be his portion. Amen. So that he will receive more and download unto us. We are saying that, Lord, bless him beyond measure. Move him to another realm, another pedestal in his ministry. We are saying that, Lord, any demon, any plan of the enemy concerning his life, his family, we come against it in the name of Jesus. Somebody, let's pray for the man of God, that the Lord will lift him onto another level, that the Lord will bless him beyond measure, that the many-sided grace of the Lord will be his portion, as he has become obedient unto the Lord, as he avails himself, Father, may you also do his wishes and aspiration for him in the name of Jesus. Preserve his life, preserve his family, preserve anything that concerns his life in the name of Jesus. Let your many-sided graces be upon his life in the name of Jesus. Father, may the heavens open unto him, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let your goodness, O Lord, be his portion. Preserve the family, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, provide for him. May he never lack in the name of Jesus. We pray for vitality. We pray that, Father, you will strengthen him in the name of Jesus. Divine strength, divine enablement, divine agility, divine fortifity. Fortify him, Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We pray that, Father, you will grant him longevity in the name of Jesus, that he will prosper in the name of Jesus. As he has given you his all, Father, may you also give him all that he requires, he needs, he requests of you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Cause him, O Lord, to do more in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Rekataya su anderia, rantable de masi anderia, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying again for KHM. We are saying that, Lord, help us do your bidding. Help us roof this, our edifice, our auditorium. We are saying that, Lord, he said 1,000 cattle on the hilltop belongs to you. We are saying that, Lord, provide. You are the provider. We come before you tonight. We are saying that, Lord, do it for us. Lord, do it for us in the name of Jesus. Somebody, let's pray that the Lord will grant us the grace to be able to do it. In the name of Jesus. Father, may you do it for us, O Lord. Wherever the means are, Father, may you cause us, use us to do it to glorify your name. In the name of Jesus. Father, may we do it, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, to glorify your name. Provide for us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Provide, O Lord. We say where there is no way, you will make a way there. Father, provide, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that will finish this edifice, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Help us, O Lord. May no Tobiah, no Samalat, no whatsoever stand on our way in the name of Jesus. Grant us that zeal that you gave to Nehemiah when he heard that the Jerusalem gate has broken and he went there to repair. We are saying that, Father, we also want to have that zeal that will help us be a builder of your church in the name of Jesus. We are building it for you, so we pray for your grace to build. We need your grace to mobilize ourselves, O Lord, that, Father, we will be able to finish this course in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Randebro asu anderia, rekata tataya si anderia, rentebrede masu kandoria si anderia, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praying on our first fruits. Amen. We are praying that the Lord will bless us as we also fulfill this covenant of fulfilling or of offering our first fruit unto him. As in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 9, he said that as we give him our first increase, he will bless us. He will fulfill the promises that he has said concerning our life. Amen. We are saying that, Father, as we do this, may your increase come unto us. As we come before you with our increase, may you increase our increase. May you add unto it. May the promises that you have said concerning our lives be fulfilled. In the name of Jesus, somebody pray over your first fruit. In the name of Jesus, you might not even know how much you are bringing, but you just pray. The Lord himself will make a way as we come before him. In the name of Jesus, he brings the money. He causes or creates our hands to make wealth. So we are saying that, Lord, we want to use the world to bless you. We want to fulfill that covenant that we have said in your word, that as we bring unto you the first things, Father, you will fulfill the promise that you have said concerning us. So we pray in the name of Jesus, O Lord, that, Father, as I fulfill the part of my covenant, as I fulfill the part of my deal, of the deal, Father, may you also fulfill your part by blessing us, by causing that your promise to fulfill in In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, 2023, we cannot remain the same. So, Father, we pray, my Lord, my God, that as we fulfill this covenant, O Lord, may there be a change in our lives, O Lord. May there be an increase, a thrive, and for us to do well. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we pray, my Lord, my God, that, Father, may we not neglect our duty, or may we not regret, O Lord, neglect fulfilling this covenant. In the name of Jesus, help us do it, and do it as you want us to do it. May we not be like we are being forced to do it, but we will do it with love, in the name of Jesus, so that we will receive the benefit that comes with it. For you say that those that diligently serve you, or diligently do as you want us to do, we will receive the reward associated with it. So we pray that, Father, help us in the name of Jesus, that we'll be able to fulfill this assignment, we'll be able to fulfill this duty, for us to receive the blessings thereof, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Help me, Lord, fulfill my duty by bringing my first thing unto you. You said we should bring the first things unto you. So we pray that, Father, help us do it as you have instructed us to do, so that your will and your provision will be our portion, in the name of Jesus, as we bring unto you, Lord, those comprehensive insurance associated with it. May we be able to receive it, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus.
Begin to magnify the Lord.
In the name of Jesus, Father, we bless your holy name, Lord. We honor you,
Lord. He loads us with daily blessings.
In the name of Jesus,
daily benefits that he bestows unto us.
We bless your holy name, Lord.
Today being the day 17, we will have to finish strong and finish well. Lift your voice and begin to magnify the Lord. Remember,
Father,
gratitude
name,
guarantees
Lord.
More.
We honor
so if you
name,
can
Lord,
say thank you, if you
glory.
Can bless him for bringing us this
in
far,
the name of Jesus, in the name
then you
of
can
Jesus.
Access more. You can receive more bliss and more blessings.
We bless your
in
holy
the name,
name
of Jesus.
In the name of
this gathering is not unto anybody, it's unto God. As you come in and out, you are coming to God. Every deed, every gesture, whatsoever you are doing, demonstrating in worship goes to God. All the glory must be to the Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Many begin, but it's not many who end. And the Bible says that the end of a thing is better than its beginning. The end of a thing is better than its beginning. For that essence, we need to finish our prayer. Thank God for bringing you this far. You can move into tomorrow's session. You can move into the next day's session. If you are not grateful for today, in the name of Jesus Christ, you may have keyed in just within this week or these few days, but we believe that God is the 11-hour work rewarder. He is the one who rewards the 11-hour worker. As you open up your faith, you can trust him. And as you thank him, he will come through for you. Come on now. In the name of Jesus, who is like unto thee among the gods, among the lords, who can be compared unto thee. We come before you, we honor you, we magnify you, we exalt you above all else. In the name of Jesus, be hallowed. Pray right now that God, I am open to you. Let the heavens be open unto me. Hallelujah. Amen. I empty myself of myself. Touch me by your power. Touch me by your might today. Lift up your voice and pray. Your healing is in the service. Your deliverance is in the service. For upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. And the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. There is a bliss for you to possess. There is a blessing. There is something miraculous for you to take. In the name of Jesus, come before the Lord. Razo kibasha, igos ados andahabo shebres, rodos kibasha ndarukuta. Ibosh ebrenda kurabata rabaya. Ikodos aramandaha. In the name of Jesus, we come before you, we honor you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this special day. We honor you for bringing us this far on this specific day, the 17th of this 21 day fasting and prayer. We open up our spirit and we say that pour out your totality into us, transform us, change us, O God, stir up the flames of your presence within us. Lord God, embellish us, O God, with your manifold presence, your manifest presence, your manifold grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Shall we please be seated in the presence of the Lord? Make strides by discipline, or thrive by discipline. Make strides, make indelible strides by discipline. That's what we're doing today. And we want to read some few scriptures. And then we will sail through with the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. We want to start from First Corinthians chapter number 9 and verse number 24. 1 Corinthians chapter number 9 and from verse number 24. Paul says that, know ye not that they which run in a race, the race of the year, the race of the grace given unto us, within these 12 months ahead of us, even less now. Know ye not that they which run in a race, run all, or everybody runs, but one receiveth the prize, one receiveth the prize. So run that ye may obtain. Don't just run to obtain. Verse number 25. And every man that striveth, every man that striveth, every man that striveth for the mastery, for excellence, for God's highest and best, number one is temperate. The word temperate there, in other versions, it's, you know, inferred as discipline. Everyone that strive to thrive. Everyone that strive for mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain corruptible crown, but we incorruptible. I therefore so run. So now he brings it to himself after the comparison. He says, I therefore so run. How do you run? How are you running the year's race? I therefore so run, not as uncertain. Also fight I, not as one that beats the air. Other version says shadow boxing. And then verse number 27 says, but I keep under my body, and bring it into subjection. Other version says, I discipline my body. Tell four people, discipline your body. Hallelujah. He says, reason being this, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway or disqualified. That lest by any means, when I have fulfilled what I have to do, I become a castaway. Please let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Please. Please. Please leave it like that. Hallelujah. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? That's okay. Touch nothing. Leave it like that. Hallelujah. Amen. Permit me to just go through Proverbs and then pick some few things there. Let me read from Proverbs chapter number 3. Proverbs chapter 3 and verse number 11 and 12. Proverbs chapter number 3 and from verse number 11 and 12. An admonition to the son. We want to look at the verse number 11 and 12 of this. It says, my son, my daughter, despise not. Can you get it for us in the New King James or the NIV? Can you get it for us in the NIV, please? All right. My son, do not despise the Lord's discipline. Do not despise the Lord's discipline. And do not resent his rebuke. Do not resent his rebuke. My daughter, my son, my child, do not despise the Lord's discipline and do not resent his rebuke. Do not resent his rebuke. Verse number 12 of same. Reason being this, because the Lord disciplines those he loves. The Lord disciplines those he loves. As a father, the son he delights in. As a father, the son he delights in. We will find the same, those of you writing, you will find the same in Deuteronomy chapter number 8 and from verse number 3 to 5 and specifically even the 5th verse. And then, of course, we will see another inference of this in Hebrews chapter number 12. Hebrews chapter number 12, looking at it from the verse number 4 to the 11th verse. Verse number 4 to the 11th verse. May the Lord God add his blessing to the reading of his word. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Tell your neighbor, advance, make strides. Tell your neighbor, advance, make strides. Tell your neighbor, thrive. Tell your neighbor, thrive by discipline. Hallelujah. Amen. Most of the time when we hear the word discipline, what comes into our mind is punishment. What comes into our mind is corrective measures. What comes into our mind is something that is harsh, that being meted out to you. Especially those of you who in our day you schooled either, you know, earlier within the 70s and then even the 60s and then the early 80s and so on, where, you know, teachers could discipline, teachers could whip. When you are late, you receive some whips. Hallelujah. And so many of you stop being late because you don't like the whips. How many are here today? Hallelujah. And so if there were to be any gratitude, you would not only thank the teacher who could whip well, but the cane he used. Hallelujah. Amen. And so you realize that there were some things and, you know, people around the neighborhood in our communal settings where, you know, other people, neighbors could discipline you even though your mother is not there or your father is not there. It's as if that if you were a child in the neighborhood, you are a child to everybody and everybody can discipline you and bring you to the place of order. Unlike today that when the teacher whips you, your father will say, come on, let's go and see the teacher. And then they will go and give it to the teacher or something. And so, you know, when it comes to discipline, we have different definitions and we have different misconceptions and pockets of opinions about discipline. Hallelujah. But God loves those he disciplines, and he disciplines those he loves. God disciplines those he loves. And we see that in Hebrews chapter number 12. Hallelujah. Amen. And so then we realize that God has a special desire to bring us to a place wherein we will become better tools in his hands for him to use. Now, discipline in other sense could even be like bringing something in order or bringing it to its rightful place so that it can be meet for its exact or destined purpose. Now, when anything is left unkept, unswept, not arranged, that thing grows out of hand. And so I personally believe that, you know, the mandate that God gave to man in Genesis chapter 2, verse number 15, where God made man and put him in the garden, he put him there not just in the word to keep and dress it, but also to bring order, discipline into the environment. Hallelujah. And then we read again and we realize that from the verse number 16 and 17 thereabout, we still then realize that, and God commanded the man to eat freely from the garden. God commanded the man to eat freely from the garden. But in the 17th verse, we see that he set out a protocol. He sets out a protocol. He says, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat of it, you will surely die. For when you eat of it, you will surely die. I've said time and again that to every environment, every space, every place, every person you meet, there are spoken and unspoken protocols. Your ignorance about those protocols is no excuse. And the ability for you to remain in that place or be able to, you know, or be banished from that place is dependent or is contingent on your ability to adhere to the protocol or not. And so then we see that in the garden, Adam and Eve were only thrown out when they went against God's protocol. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And so then I've defined protocol time and again that it is a system that communicates comfort and creates honor in an environment, a system that God has put in place. So the moment you dishonor what has been said, it means that you are frowning on that kind of authority that is above you, you know, by disobeying. And the moment you do that, every disobedience is an indiscipline, is a form of indiscipline. Hallelujah. And so Adam and Eve in an environment, put every any human being in any environment and leave the person without a constitution, there will be anarchy. There will be confusion. And so you, most of us, we understand that when you go to your second, you went to your secondary school or any institution, most of the things you, most of the time you are oriented, you are given an orientation of the school boundaries. How many went through it? And how many were punished when you? And sometimes you cannot see any boundary dividing where the mark, the end is, but there is nothing there. But when you cross that path and your senior house master catches you, or senior house mistress, you are in trouble. And so then when you put human beings in a place, there must be rules of engagement of the place. And so in that essence, yes, we are free, but we are free in terms of the, you know, up to the point where we have been orientated that this is a boundary line. You must not cross it. Then that boundary line becomes a protocol. Your ability to adhere and stay within those confines makes or is a pointer to the fact that you are disciplined. Ask your neighbor, are you disciplined? So man lost the place because of this indiscipline. Man lost his place because of indiscipline. And so all forms of indisciplines are also sin. And I pray that God will help us in the journey. Hallelujah. Amen. And so in this year, in this glorious year of thriving and making strides, the key to being in step, the key to being in step with God in our bid to making strides, in indelible strides in this year, is discipline. Somebody say discipline. So now we want to look at discipline in the essence of self-discipline. Self-discipline, self-mastery, self-governance, and self-control. Self-discipline, self-mastery, self-governance, and self-control. Hallelujah. And the greatest of all disciplines is ever is self-imposed discipline. Yes, it might be very easy going to discipline other people, but if you are able to take the plank or whatever out of your eyes, then you can see clearly and take somebody's log out of his way. Is somebody here? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And so usually I say this when I'm making some of this presentation. I say that, listen, have you been racing for years but have never seen the finish line? People are racing. Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter number 9, verse 24 to 27, that in a race many run, but only one comes first. Hallelujah. And he says that he doesn't race just for running's sake. He runs to obtain. Have you been running and never obtaining? If so, then the answer is this. Check your discipline. Check your discipline. Or better still, ask your discipline. Ask your discipline. I love the lyrics with this music group called Casting Crown. Casting Crown. They sang a particular song dubbed, you know, Does Anybody Hear Her? Does anybody hear her? And then one of the lyrics, part of the lyrics goes like this. She is running 100 miles an hour in the wrong direction. She is running 100 miles an hour in the wrong direction. She is 2 years older and 3 steps backwards in life. She is going into the shadow of the ditch, but she cannot see. She is crying, but nobody hears her. And this is an imagery of our lives. Many of us, we are kind of on a good state. We are running, but running away from the purpose. Running, but not running towards the goal. Running, but not towards the destined end. And there is no help in God for us, seemingly. And I see that we ourselves are not also ready to be helped. But I pray that tonight, discipline will come through for us. I said that may the discipline of the Lord come through for us. Hallelujah. Discipline is the avid adjuster and director. Discipline will bring or make a laser precise leader. Discipline will bring you to that plane wherein you will be cut, manicured to fit into your God-given purpose in life. Hallelujah. Amen. And so then we need to come into that place where we will understand the dominion mandate given unto us in this essence, that whatsoever you don't dominate will dominate you. And so Paul categorically said that I put my body under. One of his tripartite nature, we are body, soul, spirit. Or you are first a spirit, you have a soul, and you live in the body. We feed our soul with the word of God. Hallelujah. So that our body can draw strength from the soul, inspiration from the soul. Hallelujah. And when our soul is well fed with the word of God, hallelujah, our body falls in equilibrium. But when our soul is not well fed with the body, with the word of God, we realize that the body also goes on the rampage. What happens is that the body jumps and rebels against every instruction that comes to it. The body jumps up with all its feeling and want to be gratified, satisfied in all arenas. And so Paul said that I know myself. I could be preaching based on the instructions in homiletics, the art and the science of preaching. And I might sound that I'm anointed, but at the end of the day, I can be a castaway. Hallelujah. And so what I do is that I don't want to be disqualified when Christ comes. And this is what many many believers do. And the Bible says in the latter days, many will come and stand before you and say, God, in your name, we cast out demons. God, in your name, we sang. God, in your name, we preach, we prophesy. And God will tell you that right from the onset, I never knew you. Get thee behind me. I pray that this will not be your portion. I pray that this will not be your portion. I pray that you will not labor in vain. I pray that the grace of God will not be frustrated in your life. I pray that the grace of God will not be useless. Hallelujah. And so then there must be an exercising of dominion, because the dominion dynamic states this: whatsoever you don't dominate will dominate you. Whatsoever you don't master will master you. If you don't master sin, sin is going to master you. Hallelujah. That is why Romans says that sin shall not have dominion over us. Sin shall not have dominion over us. If sin wouldn't have dominion over us, then we must come into the bracket of discipline. Somebody say discipline. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. In life, there are things that go for, major things in Bible that God admonished us to do for ourselves, and we want to look at that. Number one, God's word requires us to discipline ourselves, or discipline yourself for godliness. 1 Timothy chapter number 4 and verse number 7. Number two, God's word in James 4:10 says that we should humble ourselves. Hallelujah. I pray that it will be so for you. James 4:8 also says so. Hallelujah. Number three, he said we should examine ourselves. So we are looking at things that we are supposed to do for ourselves. There are things you need to do for yourself. If you have not done it for yourself, it is difficult, or you become a hypocrite doing it for somebody else. Examine yourself. You have not finished examining yourself and you want to go and examine somebody. It's hypocrisy. It's hypocrisy. Hallelujah. You have not humbled yourself, but you see that somebody is proud and you want to go and tell the person that, hey, humble yourself. Meanwhile, the whole fingers are pointing to you. The fourth one is encouraging yourself. And the Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter number 30 and verse number 6 that David encouraged himself. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And so then, looking at all this, we should be able to come to the realization that God wants us to come to a place where we'll be able to apply self-discipline, discipline ourselves. We should discipline ourselves. We should put our bodies in check, put our emotions in check, check all that we need to do in order for God's name to be glorified. Tell your neighbor, pastor is speaking to you. Hallelujah. Amen. And so then we will have to look at what we call some of the misconceptions of discipline. When we look at this, we will get to know the authentic discipline. We will understand authentic discipline. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And so here we look at it, and I've already read Proverbs to us, Proverbs 3, 11 to 12. Most of the time, we look at discipline and we say that, oh, it is like some punishment, like I said. Punishment. Somebody wants to hurt you. Of course, when the enemy brings you into the place of suffering and battering and punishment, he punishes to destroy you. But God doesn't do so. God does his, he allows us to go through, if it is chastisement, you can call it punishment or correction. He does so for our own purpose, for our own gain. Hallelujah. Amen. And even states in scripture, he said, I will not let any temptation that is greater than you come to you. But with the same temptation, I will provide a way of escape. The Bible says that your light and momentary affliction is fetching for you a far weightier glory. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse number 17. And so then we realize that God's intent for allowing some states and vicissitudes of life to come to us, it doesn't come to destroy us, but it comes to build us up. Say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. Biblical discipline is purpose-oriented. Biblical discipline is purpose-oriented than mere punishment and correction. Biblical discipline is purpose oriented. When God, through scripture, brings you to a narrow place, he is like that, treating you like the butterfly. He doesn't want you to come out of your cocoon with the inability to fly the rest of your butterfly life. The butterfly coming out of the cocoon, a small hole is punched out there, and the baby butterfly is supposed to squeeze its body through the cocoon, and as it squeezes that, some juice that is not needful for its next level is drained inside the cocoon. So somebody will go out there and say, hey, this little butterfly is suffering, let me help it. If you tear the cocoon and give it the liberty to come, that juice will make the wings so heavy that the rest of its life it will be a crawling butterfly. I pray that you will fulfill your course. There are times that God brings us into narrow way. If your name happens to be Paul, Saul, and you have been destined to become Paul, then get ready for your Damascus experience. You got to get ready. You've got to get ready. And so then we should disabuse our mind of the fact that, you know, God has an intent to kill us. He wants to kill you. He's a master killer. Of course, scripture says that he gives life, he kills. But it is a dangerous thing to fall into the hands of God. I think it's Hebrews chapter number 10 and verse number 31 or so. Yeah. Hallelujah. And so then I pray that we will come to that place where we will rather do what God wants us to do. We will self-discipline ourselves before you incur divine discipline. Do you understand what I'm saying? No, okay, they say audit center is going to come. All right, but the one of the smartest things you can do is to audit yourself. Have the internal audit. Put your books in order. Hallelujah. Then for you to put your hands in your demerithim and sit down for. So now it's good. Hallelujah. Amen. Those of you growing up, let me bring that analogy. When you were growing up and your mother says that today she's going to bath you. Who is that? Who is that? They bath. And you were, or whoever. And you, in fact, that day they scrub you because you massage yourself. You play with yourself. You kill yourself softly. But when they take the sponge, those days, sapo. They scrub you. After bathing, you realize that you sleep well. Hallelujah. And so, yeah, of course, sometimes pair our disobedience and other. If God has written and scheduled that for you, no matter what you do, he's going to use you. Then you can run, but you cannot hide. But throughout the year, as we know that the end of the age is close and the coming of the Lord is near, tell your neighbor, the coming of the Lord is near. If it is so, then you better self-discipline yourself. Exercise self-restraint, self-control, self-mastery. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So it is more. God's kind of discipline, or biblical discipline, is more goal-oriented. And here, seeking, when this discipline comes to you, is seeking to develop a godly person who walks, lives, and directed by divine dictates, or walks in God's way. Hallelujah. In the season where we are going to make strides, we're going to make indelible strides, then may we make it God's way. Tell your neighbor, make it God's way. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And so sometimes in our world, our free world, where everybody wants the aku, don't touch this one, don't touch this one, don't punish this one, don't spank this one. When your child is spilling the whole milk for the week on the floor, leave them just... A kind of world that we find ourselves. People grow up and think that, oh, we tend to think of discipline as keeping others in line. But at the heart of discipline is discipling. The discipline is discipling. I said at the heart of discipline is discipling. In other words, help people become followers. Help people become followers, or helping people become followers, particularly followers of Christ. And Jesus' disciples were called so because they were the disciplined ones. They were the disciplined ones. Ask your neighbor, are you a disciple of Christ? Hallelujah. And so biblical discipline emphasizes on loving guidance and guardianship. Loving guidance and guardianship. One is for protection, one is for leadership. In guidance, you are led from point A to point Z. In guardianship, you have succor, you have the covering. Hallelujah. He will keep you under his feathers. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. And then tutelage. Here you are instructed. Hallelujah. In other words, you don't go by your social media instruction, but you receive divine guidance. Tutelage, you have instructions from the Lord, and then he protects you. His intent is to bring you to his highest and best. Amen. Unfortunately, most of our parents did it for pleasure, but God does it for our profit. And so in Hebrews chapter number 12 and verse number 10, that example is given there. It said that, for they verily for a few days chastened. Come on, go into, so that we didn't use the word chastened, NIV. So our fathers disciplined us for a little while as they thought best. But God disciplines us for our good, for our profit. And the King James says, for profit. He chastises for profit, that we may share in his holiness. So now in the King James, it says that, you know, our parents chastise us for pleasure. But God chastises us for profit. In other words, for your own benefit. Hallelujah. So you might be suffering right now. You might be going through some lack right now. You might be going to seemingly insufficiency. But suffer it to be so now, so that you will come out without blemishes. Hallelujah. For your light and momentary affliction is fetching for you a far weightier glory. Say, Lord Jesus, whatever I'm going through, whatever you have allowed, in the name of Jesus, I know that I will profit at the end of the day. As I lift up my voice to pray, help me to be able to adhere to your discipline so that I will come out profiting. Lift up your voice and pray right now. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Pray right now. Karoze bradaya. Indanarabazarabaya. Indako zebarabaya. Ekabo sharaba zorabaya. In Jesus' name. Dr. Bilkey, James Bilkey, said the other day, he said that you will never be the person you can be if pressure, tension, and discipline are taken out of your life. You will never be the person you can be if pressure, tension, and discipline are taken out of your life. Yes, you have that big dream. Yes, you have that aspiration. How many have great goals? Come on now, you have a dream. Martin Luther King, where are you? Where are you? Wave and let me see. Put the devil to shame as you wave and say, I am here. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. And so there is a place that you are going. That is why there is the need for us to afflict our soul through fasting. Fasting is not easy. Fasting is not easy. And some of you, if I'm to give you the opportunity to testify from 6 to 6, how the fasting goes, how some strange, sometimes your eyes begins to become zing, zing. And then in your left intestines cry, nice lady like you, when you are moving the, hey, are you an organist? so on. You have been through several things. When you are fasting, that is when your appetite begins to run amok. Your body, that's why Paul said, I put my body under. Paul knows what he was talking about because he mentioned something in chapter 7 of Romans, and then he said that woe is me who is caught up in this body. The good I want to do, I'm not able to do. The evil I don't want to do, is the one that I do. Woe is me, who will deliver me out of this body? And so it was all right for him to have said this. I put my body under. Listen, when you leave the bad boy body, the body will mercilessly manhandle you. The body will let you crave for things you don't. I'm telling you, sometimes even when you are breaking your fast in the wrong timing, sometimes you break it with even what you don't like to eat. True or false? You just wanted something to fill the thing, because the stomach doesn't want to stay quiet. Hello? Then you cry, you regret that you broke your fast that way. Oh, look at the soakings plus the salt. Clap for you. So, the body wants to be allowed. Your senses, your feelings, different kinds of things. Some different kinds of pictures can come into your mind. Different kinds of thoughts, different kinds of things. You even sometimes be regret. The small thing, you are angry. You want to curse somebody. You want to... Where are you? Where are you? Hallelujah. Manifestations of fasting. So for the spirit man to come to the kingship place, for your body to be the servant, and for your soul to be the servant and the body the slave, you need to go through some things. Life is not about what you escape, but what you are able to endure. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 And so one also person said that discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishment. Do you have goals? Do you have accomplishment? Goals is a bridge. Nothing and absolutely nothing demands intentionality more than discipline. And so then when we come to the place of discipline, yes, I know you are spiritual. Yes, I know you are anointed. Yes, I know you are the one who speaks the etumpan and phantom from tongues. I know that you are the one who sees, you can see even different kinds of things, birds in bow tie on Iroko trees. You can see all those things. I clap for you. But listen, if you have no discipline, you ain't going anywhere. You ain't going anywhere. Hallelujah. You ain't going anywhere, because when you leave this body, even in terms of grooming, things will grow out of proportion. Your nails will grow out of proportion. I don't want to talk about others. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So we will have to come to that place. And in that essence, we will have to look at some of these things as well. And we say that all of our decisions in life are informed by a disposition of anger. Envisage. I'm just an envisage. Imagine. From the disposition of anger, discouragement, depression, loneliness, you're tempted, resentment, you know, fear, jealousy. What kind of life do you think we would have? What kind of life do you think we would have? Hallelujah. Amen. 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 And do you know that 80% of our decisions are made up of, made from our mind? From the mind, the frame of our mind. So if that is so, and you are not disciplined in the mind, then remember that your destiny will suffer, because decisions decide destiny. Tell your neighbor, tonight's subject is for you. Say, Lord Jesus, let me be disciplined in my mind. Say, Lord Jesus, let not my emotion run amok. Lord Jesus, don't let my emotions run amok, but Lord, help me to be disciplined in my mind. In the name of Jesus, touch a bit of your hair and begin to pray. Listen, I want to thrive with you. You want to thrive with me. But if our decisions, our thinking is not sound, yesterday I made us to understand, we want to thrive with people, but if they are not sound in their emotions, I'm telling you, their decisions will be suspect. Pray right now, come before the Lord. Randos kabaya, Tony Bakaya, Ian Toribo Kotoria, Inna Nobo Zeta Rabaya, Rekobo Zadoboria, Ian Doroboria, Tozebrakaya, Ironto Zakrataya, in the name of Jesus, Ian Dorakabadabaria, Torobaya, Ian Dokabaria, Yamaka Torobaya, Torobaria, Eko Doroboria, Torobaria, Ikeba Zorabatoria, Indako Torobo Zaya. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter number 23:7 that as a man thinketh, so is he. Philippians chapter 4 and verse number 8 says that whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things of good report, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are praiseworthy, if there be any virtue, think on these things. It means that everything that we think on, if they are outside these prescription, I call the menu of mind, then we are going to be found wanting in the consequence of our decision making. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, everything is head first. Tell your neighbor, everything is head first. Hallelujah. If it's head first, then discipline makes us clear-headed. Discipline will make you clear-headed, sound-minded. God has not given us the spirit of fear nor timidity, but of power and sound mind. Love and sound mind. Is it 2 Timothy chapter number 1 verse number 7? And so then you come here, it means that a sound mind, your mentality must be right. You must be sane. You, everything within your processor must work well. Must work well. It is not your tongue. And yesterday I said, don't say I love you. That is it. That's all. That's not all. It begins, but it doesn't end there. There must be other virtues that we see. Put your hand on your head. Say, Lord, let me be sound-minded this year. Can you get us 2 Timothy, is it 1, 7? Say, Lord, let me be sound-minded. Oh, come on. Say, Lord, let me be sound-minded. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, let me be sound-minded. In the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Haroka bataya. Hatorobo zebrataya. Imajo protoya. Hallelujah. So whilst even King James is saying that here, that God has not given a spirit of fear or timidity, but of power and sound mind, the NIV says it's self-discipline. So get back there. Do you see that? Do you see that? So self-discipline, self-discipline, God has given it to you. But because of the things that are happening around us, marital issue, market issue, your own issue, children issue, different creditors, different kinds of things, academic issue, when they all come over you and issue you with their issue, you realize that you can't even discipline yourself. What you don't have to dip your hands in, you can dip your hands in. What you don't have to say, you will say. Some of you, you are wild. You begin to use Takashi. Meanwhile, you know, you are just using that as what we call defensive mechanism. Just to ward off people, fight. And everybody. And they give you Antipatapa, the name. Lord, have mercy. As a Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. Permit me to pass through the neighborhood of Proverbs chapter number 16 and verse number 32. We want to read it from the Message and the Amplify. The Amplify say that he who is slow to anger is better than the mighty. He who rules his own spirit than he who takes a city. So we most of the time pride ourselves in big games. things and other things. He who is slow to anger is better than the mighty. It's better than the mighty. When you have no self-discipline, anger will be the order of the day. Anger is an energy. When rightly directed, can be productive for you. So then you look at this place, you say that he who rules his own spirit. No, it's very easy to go and rule, controlling this one, controlling traffic. But have you controlled the traffic in your heart? Have you been able to control yourself? Have you been able to? And the word rule is a marshal. Marshal. Be able to put things under control. Don't let them outgrow the place. The Bible says God put the man in the garden. He said, make sure that things don't grow out of proportion. Make sure that they are all kept in order. And I pray this grace over your life. The message puts it this way. He said, the moderation is better than muzzle. Moderation is better than muzzle. Self-control. We're dealing with self-control, self-discipline, self-mastery, self-restraint. So we will have to come to this place where we will realize that moderation is better than muzzle. Self-control better than political power. Say, Lord Jesus, give me the spirit of self-control. Say, Lord Jesus, give me the spirit of self-control. In the name of Jesus, I put my body under. 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 Lift your voice and begin to pray. Come on, begin to pray. Come on, begin to pray. Rados kabayan toroboya. Come on now, in the name of Jesus. Come on now. There are other things that could excite us. There are other things that could look like very awesome. But listen, self-control is better than political power.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. And we said you are married to somebody who has no temper, no self-control. You fell in love. Oh, I'm falling in love. Love alone is not enough. Has the person got self-control? Else that girl will beat the hell out of you, brother. That girl will beat, and the only way to just, you know, keep your ego is that, hey, please come, I'm beating my wife. By the time they come, well, bro, they will beat you for a long time because your ego will not let you say it. Don't just be going about falling in love. Hallelujah. Thank you, bros. I love you for that. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 I love Job chapter number 5 and verse number 12, where he disappoints the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. But he going into the NIV of Sam, and we're going into the 17th verse. I just passed through here because I knew a neighbor. Sometimes you are visiting somebody, but you know that number 2, you are going to number 5, but number 2 you know. So you just pass there and greet. So I greeted this verse. That's not where I'm going. Please go to 17. Blessed is the man whom God corrects. The word correct there is discipline. The Hebrew people call it Musa, a pair friend, Musa. It's Musa. M-U-W-C-A-R. It's in there, but we will get there. Hallelujah. Amen. So he said, blessed is the man whom God disciplines, whom God corrects, who has self-control, self-restraint. Blessed is the woman whom God corrects. Say, God, correct me. Jeremiah said, say, Jeremiah chapter number 10:23. Don't show it. So then he comes here. He says that blessed is a man whom God correct. So do not despise the discipline of the Almighty. In the book of Job, the word Almighty, everybody say Almighty. Say Almighty. Say Almighty. You know, he said it about 31 times in the book of Job. 31 times. And all of them, he was inferring El Shaddai. Somebody say El Shaddai. El Shaddai is the all-sufficient one. The many-breasted one. He's breastfeeding somebody in China and breastfeeding somebody in Takoradi. Right now. Are we here? Hallelujah. The many-breasted. He can feed everyone. He feeds everyone. Even still an understatement for the prowesses of our God. And so God wants to protect us by disciplining us. And throughout the year, we are praying that God, let this be my portion. Hallelujah. Let this be my portion. In the same Job, in Job chapter number 36, a man, a brother, a young guy called Elihu. Elihu muses this way. He said, God opens our ears to instruction and discipline. Job chapter 36 and verse number 10 and 11 from the Amplified. He also opens the ears to instruction and discipline. Say, Lord Jesus, open my ears to instruction and discipline. Say, Lord Jesus, open my ears to instruction and discipline. We went through hearing God's voice in this 21-day fasting and prayer. Hallelujah. And listen, in the season of clones and counterfeits, you need to discern aright. May the Lord open your ears. You get up, you are about to go to work. May you hear through your devotional time. Your husband is going somewhere. Your wife, your children are going to school. If you can hear something, you can say the right prayers for them. Hallelujah. I'm praying for somebody because the competition you are going through in business is too stiff and you need divine instruction to always be ahead of your game. Tell four people, pastor is speaking to you. Some of you, you are playing down on the Jacobic charisma. You are a revelation away from being a millionaire. Say, I hear you. I said you are a revelation away from being a millionaire. Say, I hear you. Those who are not saying that are those who don't want to pay their first fruit. Hallelujah. Are we here? Are we in the presence of the Lord? Are we okay? Are we on course? Hallelujah. And so we must come to that place where we will hear instructions. Say, Lord Jesus, I put my hands on my ears. Let me hear instruction and discipline and commands in the name of Jesus, so that iniquity will not overshadow me, so that iniquity will not come over me in the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up your voice and pray. You can do better. You can do better. You can do better. You can do better. Come on now. Radoske baba baba ya. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So Job says that he also opens the ears to instruction and discipline and commands that they return from iniquity. Listen, the only way the enemy can have you is when you don't hear the instructions of God and you muddy your steps in iniquity. God doesn't bless mess. Tell your neighbor, God doesn't bless mess. And then this is where usually we quote the 11, but we leave the 10. The 11 says that if they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasantness and joy. Say, I am the one. Say, I am the one. Hallelujah. So if you will obey this prayer that we have just prayed, that I open my ears, oh Lord, open my ears to instruction and discipline and to your command, this verse automatically becomes yours. That if they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasantness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. As in discipline, God chastises, God reproves, God is warning, God is instructing us, God restrains us. You know, God even bonds us. When you are bonded for something, you are kept in some period of time and space and you can't do otherwise until that bonding is over. And some of the time, he does that to keep us from satanic storms. He corrects us. He rebukes us. He checks us. Say, Lord Jesus, I avail myself for your instruction and your direction. How many want to be directed by the Lord? The steps of the righteous, they are ordered by the Lord. If he can order your steps, then he must bond you. He must bond you to himself. He can order your steps, then he must instruct you. He must restrain you, that look not to the left or the right. He must check you. Say, check me, Lord. Say, correct me, Lord. That is why Joseph, blessed is the man. You are barak. You are blessed when God corrects you. And we say the devil is correcting. Hallelujah. Amen. And so that we must open up our hearts to discipline. You are working with people. You are living with somebody, or you know, your parents and so on and so forth. Or you are serving on the ministry. The pastor course is instructing, is rebuking or directing some things on you. And then you say, I came myself. You know, please let me be free. There are some of you, you are working in a place nobody can talk your matter. They have to leave you to rot. And if you have that spirit, it's not a good spirit. It's not a good spirit. Especially within the Christendom, it's not a good spirit. There are some of you, paired your titles and other things. You say that, who am I to be advised by somebody? Who, you know, in my capacity, you usually put it here, sir. In your capacity, who can advise you? Abu correction. Anytime you see yourself overripe, know that rottening is by you. I've seen it over the years, man. I've seen it, and it does happen. Listen, and then some of the times it's because of upbringing and other things that no, we were not subjected to discipline. So when you grow up and other things, even when your spouse is correcting you, it could be your wife. Say, hey, women don't talk in the house. It's the men. When the men correct, that is proper. Who says so? Go and read your Bible. Hallelujah. Are we here? You are quiet on me. Why to me? Yeah, women, most of women are their own enemies. Yeah. Because hey, leave my husband alone, let him beat me. When he beats me, then I feel better. The other day a man was in trouble. He heard that the neighbor, they were fighting. So, he was, oh no, please don't beat me. No. Said, hey, who are you? Why have you come? Leave my husband to beat me. That's where I become better. Proverbs chapter 27 verse number 5 says that open rebuke is better than secret love. Love me, show me. If you love me when I'm stealing, don't say it. If you love me when I've not taken my bath for 3 days, don't say it. Whatever, if you love me. No! Hey! Which one is this? Open rebuke is better than secret love. Can you tell your neighbor? We don't like that one. Which kind of secret love is this one? Which secret love is that? Open rebuke. Thank you. I remember growing up, my mother was a medical practitioner, my father was a soldier, but when you are disciplined, and then you are asked to go and say thank you. Who else? Did it happen in anybody's family? That's a good family. Wait for the family too. It be me, Rasha. The way my mom said the first, I said, "Yes, yes, my mom said." Yeah, he said, "Thank you. You are great. Thank you. Why did I beat you? You beat me because I went to drink the milk and I put water in the can." What did you do? Hey, I say, what did you also do? Open rebuke. The woman who somebody's daughter has come to live with you, and then your own daughter, when you are bathing them, you massage them with a sponge and other things. But somebody's daughter, you are scrubbing them. And manukola be. Ebwen. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, Pastor is shooting you with a message. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 So Proverbs chapter number 23, verse number 13 to 14 helps us in this journey from the message place. It said, don't be afraid to correct your young ones. Don't be afraid to correct your young ones. A spanking won't kill them. There's a scripture that says that foolishness has been tied in the heart of the child. A rod of correction. So you let me read this one. You can read the other one for your homework. Hallelujah. Amen. It says a good spanking. A good spanking, in fact, might save them from something worse than death. A good spanking might save them from something worse than death. Oh, may the Lord God help us. I said, may the Lord God help us. Because you know, if you, your child doesn't receive the right spanking at the right time, the child will not be able to stand against the enemy at the time when the child must do so for you, the parent, and would disgrace you. Hallelujah. One senior man of God, general, said this. He said that when you see a child crying, it is not an omen, it is not a curse. But when an adult is crying, it means that some of the cries that he was supposed to cry as a baby, he didn't cry. And so that one is not a good thing. Hallelujah. Are we in the house? Are we in the house? I want us to look at this one and we'll also pray. Hallelujah. Proverbs chapter number 5 and verse number 23. Proverbs 5:23. An undisciplined life has a reward. Death is the reward of an undisciplined life. Who is ready to die? Hello? Oh, is this the Bible? Are you sure? We are still in the Bible. Death is the reward. So if you want to go through this year without being disciplined, then death could come in different ways. Death, die, die. Or die, be die. Different kinds of death. You could be living and nothing is happening. When I said, Hallelujah. We must sit up. I said we must sit up. Hallelujah. Say, Lord Jesus, I refuse this reward. And so help me to be disciplined. Help me to be super disciplined. Lift up your voice and come before the Lord. Come on now. Let's finish day 17. Need your fire on the altar. Need your fire on the altar. Needs your fire on the altar. Needs your fire on the altar. In the name of Jesus. Ragodosa baraya. Yantoka barabazaya. In Jesus' name. Romans chapter number 6 and verse 14. Says no more dominion of sin in 2023 in Jesus' name. Amen. For sin shall not, KJV, says sin shall not have dominion over you. For ye are not under the law, but under grace. Hallelujah. Amen. This scripture goes on to declare when you get into the dominion of discipline, or you by self-discipline, trim things, manicure things, scrape off some excesses. Because what discipline does is that it releases us from excesses. The excesses of life. No, everything is good or things might be good. But anything that is overindulged in is detrimental to your own destiny. Hallelujah. For example, sugar could be good depending on what you are doing. But when you overindulge in it, it could be something else. Hallelujah. Even your friend, when you go to your friend's house plenty, the Bible says that Yeah, it's so at the end of the day, everything is good. Everything is good. So we need to come to that place where God's goodness will help us so that we will not come short of the glory of God. Amen. Hallelujah. All that the devil wants us to do is to come into hysteria, as in the Greek, to be late, to come short, to become inferior, come behind, and so on. But we are here tonight. We want to submit ourselves to the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to say the Lord, as Paul said that, you know, I put my body under. If you're able to put your body under, it is not a work God is going to do for you. Yes, we have what we call dependence discipline. Dependence discipline. I believe and trust in God for his grace to be able to discipline myself. Hallelujah. You like watching films more than reading your Bible. So there must be a discipline of abstinence, abstaining from it. But when you say by your own might, I'm going to do, you realize that you can struggle. And so I have what we call dependent discipline. I'm depending on God, not by might, not by power, but by your spirit. Lift up your right hand and say, Lord Jesus, help me by your power to put my body under. In the name of Jesus. According to your word, in James 4:7, help me to subject myself to you. Help me to submit myself to you so that I can resist the devil for him to flee. Lift your voice and pray. In the name of Jesus. Come on, begin to pray right now. Begin to pray right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So just, I just want to share some. So everybody say self-control. It is the ninth of the fruit of the Spirit. It's the ninth out of the fruit of the Spirit. And when we say that, I most of the time mention it in my messages, it's called ekratia. Ekratia. And when we say ekratia, it's the attitude, the trait of being masterful. The avoidance of excesses. Continence. Dominion, temperance. And so all acts of discipline is invariably the exercising of dominion, the dominion mandate. Tell your neighbor, exercise dominion. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And so in this essence, in looking at it from this point, we are saying that, listen, discipline as defined as the ability to hold something or master a situation irrespective of the pressure it exudes or how it comes in to taunt you. You should be able to find yourself in this. May the Lord God help us be disciplined. Say, Lord Jesus, help me to be disciplined. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Webster said several things. He said that control gained by enforcing obedience and order, or orderly, or prescribed conduct, or pattern of behavior. She also said that training that corrects, molds, or perfects the mental faculties or moral character. And of course, a field of study could be a discipline. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So nothing and absolutely nothing on this molecular world works without discipline. Even when you want to be a proper witch, you need to be disciplined. No, yeah, go into their sect. They are more disciplined. I talk about the Asiatic countries who don't have the level of your anointing, who don't pray the level of tongues you pray, but their discipline, I call it their 40%. Continuous assessment. Yes, they are 40%, they are able to rise higher. They don't pray the prayer you pray. But many of us, under the pretense of religion and other things, indiscipline, in terms of punctuality, where we have to be at what time, and so on, different kinds of things, in terms of our communication, indiscipline is everywhere. Indiscipline is, you yourself, you couldn't solve it, and you are giving birth to your children with it. Hello? Or you married somebody who is also in discipline, and you yourself, you were not disciplined. So you realize that you will have overflow of discipline. May the Lord God have mercy on us. Hallelujah. Every revival, every restoration, every recovery, every invention have been preceded and born by discipline of ordinary men and women. Every revival, I believe that you are next in line for a revival. I believe that you are next in line for a revival. Some of you, heaven has heard your great prayer. All that you lack is discipline. If you can, my God, rise up a bit, lift up the standard of discipline in your life, that God will come to pass, that aspiration will come to pass, that miracle will come to pass, the discipline of consistency in prayer, the discipline of giving, the discipline of tithing, the discipline of forgiveness. If you can be disciplined, you will not stand outside the set and watching other people wield the sword of their inventions and their whatever goals achieved. But you yourself will be a custodian of discipline. Say, Lord Jesus, help me to be disciplined enough to bed forth every aspiration, every goal, every dream. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. Friend, loved ones, watching KHM Diaspora. Yes, pastor, watching, deacon, watching. You have a goal, but discipline, discipline, consistency, being there at the same time. Whether somebody is there or not, you are there. In the name of Jesus Christ, watching in the same. If your name happens to be Noah, you watch in the same. God said that build the ark. 120 years, if you are supposed to preach the same message, you stick and stay. You don't say that somebody is doing this program and so I will do something else. If people have achieved great things, they had the discipline, they committed to some pattern of life. Some of you, your discipline should be found in your eating habit, your sleeping habit, your exercising, and so on and so forth. Pray right now. Help you. May the Lord help you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. So for you to triumph, discipline is the triggering point. And I pray that God will bring you there. If you can conquer your physical and mental being, you can conquer anything in the world. And so then we can get into the squares of just looking at this, and we will get into the depth of prayer. The discipline of engagement and abstinence. Discipline of engagement. I call them the pulls and the pushes of life. The pulls and the pushes of life. Hallelujah. Discipline of abstinence. So, when we say abstinence, something you are refraining from, you don't have to do. You don't have to do. You don't have to do. We have sin of omission and commission. Hallelujah. Amen. What you were so, we were not supposed to do that you did. What you were not supposed, you know, what you were not supposed to do that you, what you did that you were not supposed to do. And so here we were looking at abstinence. Abstinence, some of these are, you know, things that we have to look at in abstinence. Silence is an abstaining discipline. Solitude, fasting, chastity or chastity, secrecy, sacrifice, and so on. And so in engagement, as a student, you have to study. You have to go and pin your butt down, take the book and read. You have to go to read. That is engagement. Worship, you have to carry yourself. You have to pray. You've got to carry yourself. You don't feel like prayer. It's not about feeling. In the place of discipline, we say this. Don't feel to do. Do before you feel. Tell five people, do before you feel. Do before you feel. Do before you feel. Do before you feel. So in abstinence and in engagement, fellowship, you will have to. The Bible says we should not forsake fellowshipping. You have to step out there. Confession, you will have to confess. Service, you will have to serve. You have to serve. Love alone is not enough. Service as well. You have to serve. Submission. You will have to put your body under. Submit yourself to God. So resist the devil and he will flee. Hallelujah. And so why wouldn't Jesus call his disciples the disciplined ones? Why wouldn't he call him the disciples? Because they are supposed to abstain from other things. Permit me to just read these few scriptures to us and we will rise to pray. First Timothy chapter number 4 and verse number 6 to 10 from the message. You have been raised on the message of the faith and have followed sound teaching. You have followed sound teaching. Now pass on this counsel to the fellows of Jesus there. And you will be a good servant of Jesus. Stay clear of silly stories that get dressed up as religion. Exercise daily in God, no spiritual flabbiness, please. It says, work out in the gymnasium. In the gymnasium are useful. It says, but a disciplined life in God is far more so. Did you see that? A disciplined life in God is far more so, making you fit both today and forever. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to trust God that God by his power will give us a disciplined life throughout the year. Because several things will be clamoring for your time. You must be disciplined with your time. Tell your neighbor, be disciplined with your time. Be disciplined with your treasure. Tell your neighbor, be disciplined with your treasure. Be disciplined with your talent. Tell your neighbor, be disciplined with your talent. Hallelujah. Amen. And we must be disciplined with our trust, our faith trust. Tell your neighbor, be disciplined with your faith trust. Hallelujah. And so we're looking at, you know, Hebrews chapter number 12. The Bible says that in your resisting, you have not resisted to the point of shedding your blood. Hebrews chapter 12 and verse number 3. In resisting, you have not resisted to the point of shedding your blood. Hebrews chapter 12, verse number. You just show me the third verse. Verse number 3. Okay, verse 4. So, go to 5, the fifth verse. So, we're looking at the fifth verse and the 6 and the 7. So, he says this. He said, and ye have forgotten the exhortation which speaketh unto you as unto children. My son, despite not thou the chastening, can you get us NIV something, of the Lord, the discipline of the Lord, the discipline of the Lord. My son, do not make light of the discipline of the Lord, and do not lose heart when he rebukes you. Do not lose heart. So number one is this. Hallelujah. Amen. It says that my son, do not make light. Number one, God is asking us not to make light with discipline. Tell your neighbor, don't make light of discipline. The King James put it as despise not discipline. Despise it not. Don't despise discipline. Don't despise it. Hallelujah. Correction is grievous to the one that receives it. But at the end, it yields profit. It blesses. Then number two, he says that don't lose heart. In other words, don't faint. So two major things. Don't despise discipline. Okay, go back to the King James. So don't despise discipline. Number two, don't faint. Don't faint when you are disciplined. And some of the times it is not discipline that, you know, you yourself, you are meting out yourself. But sometimes God also allows some things to come. To show you, God sometimes allows circumstances to teach you or take you through a learning curve. In as much as that thing did not kill you, it is meant for some particular result. Hallelujah. And so here he says that don't despise it. And then he says that don't faint, nor faint when you are rebuked of him. Go to verse number 6, please. For whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth and scourgeth, and every son whom he receiveth. Verse number 7, please. Let's work it this out. And if ye endure discipline or chastisement, God dealeth with you as sons and daughters. For what son is he whom the father chastiseth not? Verse number 8. But if ye be without discipline, whereof all are partakers, then ye are bastards. In other words, the word there is illegitimate. Illegitimate. If you are illegitimate, then you can, nothing can be willed to you. Nothing can be willed to you. So you can sing, Yediadio, it's my not you. Yeah, was yes. So, no, you are not a son, you are not a daughter. So one of the hallmarks of you being a son is that, or a daughter is that, you must be disciplined. So that is why it says there are many other afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivered. It says that, and not sons. Can you go on for me? It says, furthermore, we have had fathers. Okay, go on to 10. Hallelujah. Amen. So it says, for they verily for a few days chastise us for their own pleasure, but God does it for our profiting. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's go on. So it says that now no chastening for the present seemeth to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yielded peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. Go to 12. Wherefore, lift up the hands which hang down and the feeble knees. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So you are not supposed to despise chastising. You must not despise discipline. You must not faint, but you must endure it. You must endure it. Tell your neighbor, endure it. Tonight we want to rise in the name of the Lord. Can you rise wherever you are? Rise wherever you are. Rise wherever you are. Rise wherever you are. As we come before the Lord in the name of Jesus, this is a missing link in many distinct life, many lives that are supposed to know, you know, that top shelf and leave to the higher pedigree. We have not found it because of lack of discipline. Hallelujah. Many a times we have the charisma but minus discipline. We have the charisma minus character. Anywhere you see good character, discipline has been at work. Anywhere you see character, good discipline has been at work. But this time around, listen, charisma can take you to a place, but character will sustain and maintain you there. So if you want to maintain where you are and even to build on, then may discipline become your portion. I said, may discipline. Raise your hands wherever you are. Say, Lord Jesus, discipline is the fruit of the Spirit. I receive temperance. I receive temperance. I receive this godly attitude and virtue in my life in 2023 as I seek your face under my steps in all arenas of my life. I look up to you for help, for strength in every arena of my life. Let the spirit of self-control, spirit of self-mastery be my portion. Help me to be self-disciplined in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and begin to pray wherever you find yourself. Come on now, you can do better. Come on now. Come on now. Yando robo zado robo ya. Yando rako tarabaya. Yando roka darabaya. Shera bobo bobo zado robo ya. Yako torobo zato robo ya. Sheka bataya. Your competence will go nowhere. Your competence will be blunt. Your competence will not receive illumination if you are not disciplined. Pray right now in the name of Jesus. In this year that God has blessed us in the name of Jesus, discipline can help you be a hard worker. In the name of Jesus, educationally, in balance, in other things, come and pray right now in the name of Jesus. Rando se gratoria, rebobo se gratorica, yando roboka naboria, robo se tarabaya. Discipline of abstinence, discipline of engagement. Yando robo se dakabaya. The Lord will give you mastery. Come on, begin to pray. Friends and loved ones, wherever you find yourself, lift your voice, come before the Lord. Let us call on the name of the Lord. May He help us. We pray, my God, anything, my God, that fight discipline, that fights me, my God, any works of the flesh, any members of my body, that fight to God, in the name of Jesus, I put it down. In the Rokataya, Yakabo Zaraba. In that name, say, Lord Jesus, I put my body under. I put my body under. Based on the confession. Based on the confession of Apostle Paul, I declare, I put my body under, so that I will not be a castaway in this year. I declare right now, my body will not rule my being. My body will not dictate things to me. I subject it under the power of the Most High, under the fruit of the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus. Sister, brother, clap your hands and pray. The body is a bad boy. When you leave it, it will exert its authority over you.
I subject my yes, body God, my mind, under the influence of
my
the
heart belongs
under the power
to you.
Of the Holy Ghost, under the leadership my of the soul. Holy Ghost, my body will not lead me, my flesh will
Lama,
not lead
come on, lift
me.
Up your voice.
In the name of Jesus, the flesh will Sheba not
ba ba ba
lead me.
Sheba
in the
ba
name
ba
of Jesus,
Shaka
I subject my emotions,
yes, da ba
I subject
da ba
my body,
yo ba da ba da
under the influence of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God wired and designed His world so much that you can't do without discipline. If the Holy Ghost is the resident God on earth, then His one of His hallmark is temperance, self-control. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 You are not the only one who has anger and emotional tantrums and other things and so on. Hallelujah. Many a time what distorts our decision making is our emotions that are not kept. Emotions that are not kept. And some of us, we are not ready to change. We don't want anything to change. You want big dreams, but you don't want to change. Then nothing will change around you. That is the truth. Tell your neighbor, change. Tell your neighbor, change. Tell the other one behind you, change, change. Hallelujah. Amen. And so we must come before the Lord and desire Him that He will work on us so that we will evolve. We will become better. We will change. Amen. Hallelujah. Many a time, those of you who read the devotion, many a time when you, what do you call it? You are overly emotional and your emotions are not kept in check. Your emotion can exude or manifest anger. You can manifest some raw feeling. Different kinds of things can show up that is untamed. Hallelujah. And when some of these things happen and there is no self-control. Let me say that we are all cars. We are all cars. And we are driving on the road, but we all don't have brake. I said we don't have brake. I said we don't have brake and we are driving. What will happen? Hallelujah. So even cars have brakes. We have self-control. Tell your neighbor you have self-control. I have to say it. There are things you say you can never take them back. It will haunt you, haunt your children, haunt your children's children because of your ill emotion. And if you are listening to me, you can go and research it. When people are narcissistic, they don't only become overpossessed and possessive and other things, they also have the attitude of not wanting to change. They always see that, no, it's not my anger, it is you. And when you find such people in marriage, they are your spouse, or you are working with them, I'm telling you, you will have a hell of time. Because they never see anything wrong with them. Everything is about somebody. They never change. When such people are in political parties, they can just shift from one party A to party D. I thought you were in this party. Tomorrow you see them here. When something is happening there and they don't like it, they will just shift camps. Because they don't want to change. But you see, that's why when you are marrying, don't just fall in love. Check whether that spouse can evolve. That fiancé, whatever, is teachable. If the person is teachable, then you are safe. Because when children begin to come into the marriage, there will be different decision making there. When they start going to school, there will be different decisions there. If the person is already, you will have problems. Tell your neighbor, pastor is speaking to you. Hallelujah. And so we want to come before the Lord. I wrote something in the devotional. I said that, listen, anytime that your emotion is untamed and you are making decisions, your thinking break, your neocortex stops working. It doesn't work. It's your paleocortex that works. Your emotional brain that goes for feeling. I feel for Eba. I feel for Egusi. What do you feel for? Pounded yam. I check it. So now, it just goes feeling galore. Just goes like that. But when we live like that, it's as if we are cast without break. The world is watching. Tell five people the world is watching. They are watching you. They are watching you. You have no self-control. You have no self-control. Nice lady like you, when you shake yourself, you even forget that your blouse is torn. You are fighting. Leave me alone. Today I'll show them when AC is on. Your thinking brain is not working. We must end this thing. Hallelujah. How do you do this and still become anointed? How do you do this and you still preach? How do you do this and you still prophesy? Who, Papa? Up your voice and begin to pray that God help me to leave anything, any excesses in my promotion. Some of you, the works of the flesh, anger, your anger. When you come to church, you try, even you become moody. Pray right now in the name of Jesus. Pray right now. Because there will be different issues that will come and try your life. There will be different challenges that will come and test your life. Everything is tried in this molecular world. Everything is tested in this molecular world. In the name of Jesus, pray right now. Hallelujah. 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 I also want us to come to this realization that if the God that we serve requires self-control, ekratia, it means that it is one of the ingredients and virtues we can't do without on this planet Earth. We can't do. Tell your neighbor, you can't do without discipline. Hallelujah. It's the motherboard for all destinies and great goals. If that is so, then you should get to that understanding that if you refuse to be disciplined, life itself will discipline you. The only difference will be that the timing will be different. If you refuse your mother's discipline, you can just go on, because your mother, he cannot throw you away. They will keep on feeding you, grow fat. But after some time, life itself will discipline you. So nobody runs away from discipline. Tell five people, nobody runs away from discipline. Number one. Number two. Number three. I remember several years, my father, when one day he said he will beat me, I should go and bring the cane. He said I should go and bring the cane. And my day, our cane was a rifle string, the one they used to hold a gun on soda. So should go and we had it in sizes. So go and bring one. If there is one, if your punishment is heavy, you go and bring the big one. Go and bring it. And I thought that he had forgotten. So I ran around and he was playing with me. Until I went to bed. I was sleeping and they woke me up. Didn't I tell you to go and bring the rifle? Go and bring it. While sleeping. Hey! Listen, discipline will chase you. I'm telling you, and the discipline that is supposed to be a wind will become a wild wind. If you don't succumb to discipline, it's a fearful thing. If God is calling for self-discipline and you are running away from it, they are rebuking. They should take their work. They should take this one. Hey, I won't sell their bread again. And all those, they are telling you that your life is... He said that you are telling me, yes, but you should tell me in secret. Open rebuke is better than secret love. What you did you do it in secret? Hello? Are we here? And then another truth is this. I hope you will write it somewhere. Another truth is this. If you are disciplined, then since life is a cycle of crisis, less discipline will find you on the way. I said less. But if you are not disciplined, you can't postpone discipline. If you do, you will meet it in a grandiose way. Can we lift up our hands wherever we are? Say, Lord Jesus, I receive the anointing for self-control. I receive grace for discipline now. In the name of Jesus, all arenas of my life, works of the flesh that I must do without, help me, Lord. Attitudes that will not help me rise to the level you want me to be. Lord, I put them down. I put my body under. Help me by your grace. Give me the discipline of abstinence and engagement in all my ways throughout the year. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and pray. Come on, lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Some of us, we love people who pamper us. People who sing our song. They always sing your praise. They don't rebuke you. They don't correct you. Come on, pray right now. Shaboskeraya. In the name of Jesus. Shekadora babozeria. Rebabo zetoria. Yebabo zedebaria. Shatoroki daro. Rebabo zeteria. Robabo zite. Rokito rababasaya. Robabo zeterebaria. Shebaba rabaya. Yakado zerebaya. Shetarabaya.
To stay disciplined
in the name of
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Your maturity is in the boardroom of discipline. Your proving is in the boardroom of discipline. The best part of you is still also in the boardroom of discipline. So then, if you don't allow discipline to have its full course, then you'll be lacking of several things. Lift up your hands. If you are not proven, you can't be used. The Bible says if any vessel will set itself apart, it will be meet for the master's use. In the name of Jesus, say, Lord Jesus,
help me
to go through the necessary discipline.
The necessary discipline.
In the name of Jesus,
prove me.
Try me.
Test me.
Prep me for the grace stages. You have set for me in this brand new year. Lift up your voice and pray to God. Come before the Lord. Yes, oh God. Your proving is in it. Your testing is in it. Your preparation is in it. Come on, lift your voice. Rodo Zebrea. Shago Zedea. Roto no robos. Yeah. Oh, ba. Yando rokabando rabaya. Yato kabaraba. Yabato rabakabaria. Yato rabaya. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We are praying that God will help us develop great habits from our discipline routine. You have been able to go through this 21-day fast. Today is the 17th day. If there has been some habit of consuming things that you can be addicted to, or doing things, watching things, or saying, and because of this fast you have developed some habits, good habits, and you must have a routine with them. You must be consistent with them. Tell your neighbor, pastor is talking to you. Maybe you were procrastinating reading books and so on, but during this fasting you have been reading, you have been trying to keep on with the good habit. Tell your neighbor, keep on with the good habit. Hallelujah. So here I usually say that still maintain that great habit with deliberate discipline as you move on to build new ones. Hallelujah. Say, Lord Jesus,
help me
maintain my great habits,
with
deliberate discipline. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. Come on, pray right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Listen, all great people have great habits, and so habits are not always in the wrong. There are good habits. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And so, having said this, we want to say that, Lord, help me to be accountable to somebody. One of the ways to build proper discipline is to find mentors. I'm not calling for tormentors. Find mentors. Tell you never find mentors. Hallelujah. Find somebody you'll be accountable to. That the person can see you and say, no, you don't wear this dress. No, you don't do this one. You don't talk that way. It's not a good thing. You might be your own madam with your own yacht and plane, but the mentor is not interested in your comfort, but your character. Did you hear that? Hallelujah. And God is more interested in your character than your comfort, your convenience. And so we must be able to come to that place that somebody can call you and then say this, and then you will adhere, you will align. Many of us, we want to be freelance because your own will, even God, surrendering your will to God is wahala. How much more mentor? So you see that ever since then, you have had several people mentoring, but you never stay under one umbrella. Hello? When this one whips you, then you go. Who says so? Every mentor will whip you. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, find somebody you can be accountable to. Amen. You can come and say that, please, when you see me that, I'm not doing this well, please call me, rebuke me, I will accept it. Whom are you accountable to? I'm asking you a question. Whom are you accountable to? He said, I brought myself and I will take myself. You are your own organ. Hello? Find a mentor. Find somebody you stand under. Who is pastoring you? Who is watching over your soul, as the Bible put it? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. No matter how high you go, you should have somebody. Some of the times, even the people that you have might be, even you might be older than them, but you tell them, you could even make your own child, one of your children, accountable, you know, to, you know, you can be accountable. But when you see that my temper is coming, come and whisper into my ears, oh mommy, your thing is coming, mommy, this one, the thing is hot, mommy, this one, it is, no, it's terrible, it's Tarzan, like Pastor Paddy has been saying, it's Tarzanic. And by the time you realize, your temper will come down. Whom are you accountable to? The question is, will you find somebody to be accountable tonight? It's not about just coming and praying and go away. Whom are you accountable to? One about my for which you win him. Hallelujah. Who would do that? Who would do that? Lift up your hands. I know you're quiet on me. Yeah, it's good. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's not just about talking tongues and praying and prophesying and then and going and singing and whatever. There is more to life than we can see. Talk to God right now. Talk to God. Talk to God. Nobody can correct you. So you cry. Where are you going now? Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you. As a living sacrifice, Lord, I offer you. Lord, I offer you my life. Let me sing it one more time. Oh, Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything, wherever you are watching, lift up your hands. Use it for your glory. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you. Lifting my praise to you. As a pleasing sacrifice, Lord, I offer you my life. Lord, let's get into the stanza. You are God. Oh, all that I am. Come on now. All that I have, I lay them down before you, oh Lord. Regret all my accolades, the joy and the pain, I'm making them yours, Lord.
Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through,
use it for your glory, Lord.
I offer my days to you,
lifting my praise to you, as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Say this, Lord Jesus, I come before your holy throne and I ask for your mercies in this season where I'm supposed to make strides as I thrive along. I ask for the spirit of discipline, self-discipline, self-control, self-mastery, self-restraint. Let this be my portion. I come before you that I will be called your child. For blessed is everyone, blessed is everyone whom God corrects. Correct me, Lord. Instruct me, Lord. Guide me, Lord. Guard me, Lord. Govern my life, Lord. Lead me to where I belong. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I put my body under. I put my body under. I submit myself to you. I resist the devil. And then he will flee. Help me, Lord, to overcome this life. By the power of self-control. By the power of discipline. I receive divine enablement. I receive divine enablement. I receive dependent discipline. I receive dependent discipline. In the name of Jesus. Whatsoever I must abstain, help me to abstain. Whatsoever I must engage, help me to engage. In the name of Jesus. Help me, Lord. Revive me. Refire me. Take me there by your power. In the name of Jesus, I conquer every old habit by your blood, by your grace. I conquer every old habit. Sin will not have dominion over me. Sin will not have dominion over me. I redevote my life to you in the light of discipline. In Jesus' name, amen. If you are receiving, put your hands together to the glory of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When we're praying at the point where I realized that some of you were scared when I said, if you are not disciplined, discipline will find you. And it's true. It's true. It's true. It's true. And then the one you didn't receive the lashes from, the other one that is going to whip you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. God has made this world beautiful, and all that we have to do is to align and obey him. There is no other way to be happy in it than to trust and obey. Take an offering. Hallelujah. And as we bring our offering, we just want to remind us that it's the season of first fruit, and we are bringing our first fruit before the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Mrs. Joyce has done the series and the various editions out there. And listen, hallelujah, is the blessing, the promise to come. God has designated that first things belong to him. Hallelujah. If we bring the first, the rest is governed by him. The rest is governed by him. And so let's take our offering as you come. Make sure you take a jacket if you are not here, but in a different continent watching. It's first fruit time. Hallelujah. Sunday, we're bringing our special first fruit before the Lord. We'll end the service with a communion service. Tomorrow is the octagon of wealth. You don't want to miss it for anything. It's an anointing service for our world creation, world transfer. We are getting into the supernatural. The season of instruction has come to another point, and we are taking it further into the season of the supernatural. Hallelujah. You don't want to miss tomorrow. Come and come early. Amen. And on Friday is also the third level anointing. Why would you want to miss this? Put your hands together to the glory of God. Hallelujah. The way you are clapping is as if you don't want it. Hallelujah. So we are all coming. Amen. Prep yourself. God has been good. Today is day 17. Some of you are saying, yeah, let me finish. Let me finish so that... Hallelujah. May you finish so that your dreams and aspirations will come true. Amen. Lift the offering. Let's pray. Father, this is our offering. Let it be acceptable in our sight. We pray that, Lord God, use it as a seal for a disciplined life, self-discipline, self-mastery to your glory against all odds in the name of Jesus. Bless friends and loved ones who are also giving online all over the world in the name of Jesus. Touch their lives, oh God, as they prep themselves for their first fruit in the name of Jesus. Help us to journey at your command. Let us come experiencing your power even tomorrow and Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. May your name be glorified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God richly bless you. We have closed. Come your way at another time. Amen. My life, my soul
belongs to you.
Come on, work it.
My love.
Come for the envelopes if you don't have it.
My love.
God bless you. You have done well.